Hello students, this is Vishi Agrawal. Today in this video we are going to discuss a story, Daylight in the North. Is an Inuit folk tale. So what are Inuit folk tales? Inuit folk tales are Native American myths from the icy polar regions bordering Canada. These regions spend 6 months of the year in semi-darkness and severe cold. So the story we are going to discuss in this video is a local myth about how daylight came to the region for 6 months. So let's start a story. A long time ago, the world of the north was always in darkness. The Inuit people living there used to light candles all the time since there was darkness. So they used to light candles all the time. Two brave Inuit once decided to travel south to unknown lands. After 5 years, they came back full of stories. They talked about Greenland, grassland, orange land, rainy land, and sand land. They told everyone about the fireball hanging in the sky, giving the light of 1,000 candles burning together. And what is that fireball? That is sun. Now, each and every story narrated by the two brave Inuit made people wish for light, light, and light. They stopped their daily chorus. The two brave Inuit had become old and weak. They tried their best but could not bring the fireball to the north. They were horrified to see the sufferings of the people living in that region, but they were unable to do anything. They wished the eternal darkness would fade away one day. The Inuit people did nothing but discuss about daylight. The inactivity of the elders deprived the children of food. The peaceful land of the north became a horrible dark place full of inactive people. Since they were not doing anything, so they became inactive. The soul of the north could not bear this grief. She took the form of a bird and flew towards the south in search of daylight. When she reached the south, she landed on a tree to rest. The sun was rising. There was a warm glow all around. People had started coming out of their homes for their daily chorus. While the soul rested, the chief of the village left on a hunt with his hunters. Village ladies went to the river singing together. The soul was marveling at the happiness of the people when a baby started crying loudly. The chief's daughter came along with her crying brother. She tried to soothe him with things to eat, toys to play, a beer cup to cuddle, wolves to ride, but the baby did not stop crying. The soul turned herself into a speck of dust and landed on the girl's parka. "What's wrong?" the girl asked her younger brother. The soul drifted into the baby's ear and said softly, "Tell her you want to play with a ball of daylight." The baby did as instructed by the soul. The chief's daughter became very angry at her brother's demands. She was not supposed to touch the light. It was the most precious thing for her people. When the baby did not stop crying, the chief's daughter tied a piece of string to a small ball of daylight and gave it to her brother to play with. She carried her brother and the ball of daylight into the courtyard. There the soul turned back into a bird, grabbed the ball by its string and flew away quickly. When she arrived home, the Inuit people were overjoyed. "We have daylight now," they cheered. "We can see the whole world as well." The soul warned them, "It's just a small ball of daylight. It would need to rest sometimes, so you won't have daylight for the whole year." That is the reason why the people of the frozen north have half a year of daylight and half a year of darkness. So what's the moral of the story? The moral of the story is action is the real measure of intelligence. That is, if you just wish for the things you want to have but you don't do something, do action for those things, then you can't have it, na? So that's why it is said that action is the real measure of intelligence. So students, I hope you like the story. Thank you. Take care.